started in Ward Melville High School, where Alex Layton, while tinkering in AV, changed the course of history.
Guys, I just remembered the hyperspace drive. You're just in time for me to test it out.
VW1977 models. And
yes,
there's a life form aboard. It's a Leeralien.
What? Well, we got rid of those Leeraliens on Secretary 6, where we sold them to an Orion slave trader. Give me a picture of him. God, he looks more hideous than before.
USS Melville, this is Leer speaking. Field Marshal for Life, Dr. Idi Amin Dada Leer, intergalactic Führer of all Leer aliens. Come in, please. I would like to sit down and possibly negotiate an interstellar SEP program. Let me repeat that, an interstellar SEP program, because this is all unbelievable.
Never! Damn those Leer aliens and their cursed SEP program! Get me interested. Because of this dire crisis, we're going to run away! Navigation status.
We've landed.
Sciences.
I can't find them on the screen, sir.
Communication.
All channels are clear.
Well, gentlemen, I think we're finally rid of him.
Sir, there's something interfering with the central computer. It's coming from the new ship.
But, look! And now?
Rich!
Rich!
Don't
take! It's no use, Captain. Your crew is under my control now. There's nothing you can do.
Engineering! Life support! Computer control! Anybody!
Dr. Pond here!
Well, finally!
Sir, I have discovered the disease they are all afflicted with.
What is it, cartilage?
Hypoexmania. The fear of not finishing watching a Monty Python episode.
Medical to Captain. Medical to Captain.
Time medical.
Sir, I've discovered that if we break out of the space-time warp, the Monty Python tapes will be reversed, and the Monty Pythoexmania will be cured.
That's very good. Incidentally, why weren't we affected in the first place?
That's a simple question, you blithering wojo. It's a rerun. We've seen it before. We are immune.
Engineering the bridge. I'm ready, Captain.
Very well. Stand by. Engage.
Upset stomach, gas, indigestion, and heartburn.
This guy, what a turkey! He never takes good care of himself, and now he has to figure out something about
this. I think I'll use some Pepto-Dismal.
Oh no!
Thank you.
Ship's log, 2 years, 3 months, 27 days, 14 hours, 12 minutes, and 32 seconds after launch. The Melville is operating at peak efficiency. For many months, we've been searching the galaxy for our old friend Leer, and have finally caught up with him. His ridiculous spaceship is in a parking orbit around the fourth planet of this system, the Terrace Baker model of the Laundry Pisani 12. Leer's sensors have not yet detected us, and it appears as if we can execute our grand plan. What we are about to do may seem cruel and heartless, but we must rid ourselves of the galaxy's greatest menace, Lieutenant Anthony Coates and his infernal welder squad.
Man, tell the boarding party in the transporter room to stand by.
Yes, sir. Who are you sending on this one, sir? Not the Knights of Momus, I hope.
No, it's not that simple. We need somebody with absolutely no scruples whatsoever. People who will stop at nothing to get the job done. The Welder Squad!
Captain to transporter room.
Transporter room, Captain. I'm ready to beam them all over to Leer's ship.
Lieutenant Coates, do you know what to do?
Of course I know what to do. They don't call me Floyd because I can't tie my shoes, you know. What do you take me for? Some sort of wojo?
In the interest of morale, I want to answer that. Prepare to beam over.
Attention!
Weller squad, all present and accounted for, sir. Ready to beam over.
Well, energize before it's too late.
Yes, sir. Energizing now.
Are they gone?
Yes! Yes, by God, they're gone! We actually pulled it off! I don't believe it! What a bunch of rubes those guys are!
Finally. Thank God.
All right, chipmunks, got your hair on straight?
Wah-wah! Wah-wah!
Sing it out, boys, this is gonna be great! A one, a two, a one, two!
Close your eyes!
Against the
celebrating with some turkey nights and moments. This is the Welder Squad, the big time. Coach to Melville, come in, Melville. Coach to Melville, come in, Melville. Mission accomplished. Coach to Melville, come in, Melville. Melville? Gordon, wait. Anybody, come on, I can take a joke, come on. Coach to Melville, come in, Melville. Coach to Melville.
What's the matter, Welder Poole? Something wrong with your equipment?
Right, I should have known from the beginning, you know, these Czechoslovakian parts and all that. Yeah. That must be it, right? Coach to Melville. Coach to Melville. Come in, Melville.
Whoa, Joby.
Coach to Melville.
Coach to Melville. Come in, Melville.
Dan, turn that time the hell off.
Come in, Melville. Melville.
And he probably thinks there's something wrong with his equipment, too.
Yeah, poor Leer.
If anybody deserves to be put up with Coates and his welders, it's Leer. Anyway, take us out of orbit.
Aye, aye, sir. Out of orbit. Warp factor one.
Pipes are clogged.
What about the emergency batteries?
I'm on my way to the circuitry room now to activate them. I'll sort you out.
What has that ward your Osorio done to the lights, my friend?
Science wonderful. Oh, sorry to Captain.
What is it?
I'm activating bridge power systems now. Engineer Captain.
Bridge, Layton here.
Captain, batteries installed and operational. We have about 14 and a half hours left of power.
Good. Get to work on the main generators next.
Right.
How long before the generators are fixed?
I'd say about 5 hours, sir.
Sir, the self-destruct monitor standby is activated.
What? I'm sorry, did you hear that?
Don't worry, it's probably just taking the power field. It has a built-in auto check, you know. As long as it doesn't go to active, it's all right.
It's active!
I'm gonna fix the generators, bye!
Attention, the seal has been broken in sick bay. The seal has been broken in sick bay. Contamination is localized. Self-destruct has been placed in ready condition. Should the contamination be spread, an arming verification will be requested from the captain. There is no cause to panic. This is a pre-recorded announcement triggered by condition amber alert status.
What?
Han's probably messing with those germs of his again.
Dan, get me into the ship and then give me that Wojo pond.
Yes, sir.
Speaking. The computer has just declared amber alert. Please remain calm. This does not mean ship will self-destruct. Self-destruct will occur only upon contamination of an entire deck and only upon my direct order. Please remain calm.
Dr. Pond is waiting for you on the intercom, sir.
Very good.
Pond, what happened?
I guess I knocked that clam jar of plague over.
Who is this?
This is Dr. Pond. Who did you think it was, Anthony Coates?
God, don't say that.
What happened to your voice?
I really don't know. It's sort of strange. Everything was fine until that full jar of plague fell off the table.
The computer's still doing there.
But I have to go to the bathroom.
How?
Who was that? Tell Monty mouthing off again.
That's Tala Monty.
The captain has armed the self-destruct unit.
What?
Repeat, the captain has armed the self-destruct unit.
That's what I thought it said.
Please refer to reference manual number 34ASC2 in the Deck System 340 series for further instructions on proper dress for self-destruct. I just want to take this opportunity to say that I've never worked with a nicer bunch of humans. And I'm sorry, you're all going to be blown to smithereens.
Asario!
Yes, Captain.
What's going on?
The humidity is wreaking havoc with these circuits.
Never mind the technical jargon. How do I turn it off?
Use your disarm key.
What disarm key?
The one around your neck, you rojo.
Oh, right.
Where is he? Kill him. Kill him?
I'm gonna kill him! I'm gonna kill him!
Crazy Eddie. A store we can get anything. For five times less than its original price. You can get stereos, sound equipment, even tape recorders. This one is worth $150, and now it's cut down to $9.95. Yes, a Crazy Eddie's, his prices are really insane. I mean, who else in the world could have anything of those, especially those equipment. It's so expensive. They're so insane. It's unbelievable. It's like this crazy money.
Crazy Lenny, his prices are insane.
Ouch!
Ship's log, supplemental. Because of Dr. Pond's carelessness, and Chief Engineer Osorio's incompetence, the computer has activated self-destruct programming. Dr. Pond has been quarantined in sickbay, along with a highly contagious disease he has let loose. I have called a meeting of the appropriate department heads so that we can find a solution to the crisis now facing us.
Okay, Melville is in big trouble. Cheryl, has there been any progress with the computer?
No, sir. The computer refuses to disengage self-destruct. If Osorio hadn't connected the self-destruct before checking the wiring, we wouldn't be in this mess anyway.
Don't blame it on me. Blame it on Pond. It's his fault. He's the one that dropped a bottle of plague on the desk.
Now, wait a minute, you blithering wojo. If your generators hadn't blown up, I wouldn't be in here with my legs crossed. Why didn't the designers of this tub put a bathroom in here someplace anyway?
It's irrelevant, Pond.
Anyway, it's Layton's fault.
What?
Yes, you're the one that used full power when I told you not to. This tub can't handle full power.
You didn't say full power.
Well, the computer said you said full power.
Well, don't you bring my computer into this.
Well, why doesn't it have disengage programming?
Well, if the freaking sciences didn't use it to play Pong
Wall Street. What about engineering and their damn power?
Quiet. I have a headache.
You didn't say you had a headache last night.
Wait, I'll make you feel. I'll give you headache tablets if you simply let me go to the bathroom.
Oh,
shut up, Pond! You'll have to stay in there at least another 2 hours.
Oh, God, no!
Sorry, Al. Yes. How are we supposed to disengage?
Well, the plans. Oh, here we go. The schematic diagram is very simple. There's really no real danger. I mean, as long as we get rid of that disease in sick bay, the computer should disarm the self-destruct and it should be no problem at all.
You know, there's one quick way of getting rid of that disease. Depressurizing sick bay.
Leave it to Del Monte to come up with an idea like that.
That's Del Monte.
Good idea, but it's risky. There's a lot of expensive medical equipment in there.
Now, wait a minute.
But it would work. The computer would disengage self-destruct the moment the disease was eradicated.
Now, hold it. You aren't the pressurizing sick bay. I'm the only surgeon you've got.
Yeah, so what?
I'm the best bartender in the whole damn quadrant.
That is a problem. But fortunately, the safety of the ship is my greatest concern.
Besides, I have a 10-year stock in my cabin.
You can't do this to me! I've got rights!
I'm a human being. Why, the Geneva Convention says that I...
Okay, how long will it take to depressurize sick bay?
Well... You know, it really shouldn't take too long. I mean, the warp drive calculations would have to be reprogrammed. And then, of course, we'd have to rewire the computer. And Cheryl's core would have to be erased. But then we'd have to also probably recircuit the A-124. Because Delamonte's been using that for his games. We'd have to rewire your control board in the bridge and also recircuit the circuitry room. It shouldn't take really too long.
These Wojos aren't gonna space me. Hey! And I've gotta go to the bathroom.
Also, have to secure the airlocks and make sure that the explosive decompression doesn't result when we try to open it up. And,
What's that?
It's the alarm, sir.
Attention! Attention! Contamination has spread to deck 2. Self-destruct is now sequencing and countdown has commenced. Countdown has commenced. There are now 15 minutes to self-destruct and counting.
Captain, look!
Oh, Captain, what's going on? I'm frightened.
You're frightened? You want to know what's going on? The ship is going to blow up in 15
there
minutes.
There are now 14 minutes and 40 seconds. Until
what about short-circuiting the self-destruct unit?
It's possible. Of course, we have to override the security system and make sure it doesn't cause a status alert. If not, we'd be in big trouble.
All decks will be sealed off in 3 minutes.
Get going, everyone, to your stations. Sorry, where are you going? To the library to get the service manual.
Where is she going?
The library's that way.
Going to blow up in 13 minutes.
There are now 12 minutes and 28 seconds until self-destruct.
I want everybody to remain calm. There is no cause for panic. We at the bridge are doing everything in our power to keep the situation under control. This is the captain out.
That should calm them down.
Oh, shut up, Spike. Damn, get Osario on the view screen.
Attention, all decks are being sealed off.
No, Monty, can you stop that?
Yeah! Del Monty, do your job!
No, sir.
And that's Del Monty!
Stop to think that they maybe don't want you back.
Nah, that's absurd. It's an equipment failure, like you said before. You remember when I came on the ship? But like you said before, when I came on the ship before? You remember.
It's all, when I came. It's okay, kid. Whatever you say, don't worry about it. While you're here, why don't you give a presentation on the... A set presentation on the Euglena half-hour.
No! No, 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 no. Show them or give me your communicator.
Coach to Melville. Coach to Melville. Come in, Melville. Coach to Melville. Come in, Melville.
$50 says he won't make it in time and his ship will blow up. All right, you're on. Hey, Tom, you want to get in on this?
What are the odds?
25-1 if he makes it, even money if he doesn't.
Okay.
Cut that out.
$5 says he makes it.
Cheapskate. Minimum is 10.
Oh, all right.
There are now 10 minutes until self-destruct.
Definitely mine on the card. Let's see here.
I'll toss you for him.
No. He's mine. Good. They're a little heavy.
Oh, yes, they make them plump.
We'll lighten them up down there.
How am I going to make my quota?
You'll find the angelic types down there. This is mine.
Go, Russ. I was out, Turco.
It was not. The circuit was broken.
Sure.
If only we could evacuate in time.
It wouldn't do any good. All we've got are a bunch of old school buses, and you know how those things guzzle gas.
We could beam aboard your ship.
The mothers are there!
I'd rather die! Captain, I'm frightened.
Okay, sure.
Leave it to Del Monte to crack on the pressure.
That's Dalabusty.
Intruder in level 5. Intruder in level 5. Intruder defense circuits have been activated. Depressurizing level 5.
Pardon. I want my $10 back.
You've been drinking again, Captain.
Listen, I got a deal for you. You want to be an officer, kid? This is my first mate, she's 15.
Osorio, you've got 60 seconds of air left. Quick, before the laser picks you up.
Voice identification requested. Grasp identified as Commander Robert Osorio, Chief Engineer. Clearance to enter has been granted. The door is now open.
Osorio! Laser! Duck!
Oh,
Malfunction in security control circuits has caused abnormal termination of intruder alert.
Can't you get a picture of him?
Sorry, sir. Security system's been deactivated. I think I can get audio, though.
What the hell's he doing down there?
I'll bet you he's got that cute little computer technician with him.
My, you've got a dirty mind. I ate my hands on it for months.
Well, excuse me!
Oh, shut up! Osorio, get your hands off that door! Get to work! Osorio, can you hear me? You've got 2 minutes before the ship blows up!
There is now 1 minute and 45 seconds until self-destruct.
Whatever!
I know it!
Self-adjusting retroscope. Self-assimilating.
What are you doing?
I'm looking at a damn manual. Self-congesting sewage tanks. Self-destruct circuitry. Adjust one.
Troubles will be over in just about a minute.
There are 17. Now 37 seconds one. Until self-destruct.
That fails.
What? Ever?
Captain Smoke, nothing in this damn manual works.
Well, try something else. You've got 30 seconds.
There are now 20 seconds until self-destruct.
All right.
There are now 15 seconds until self-destruct. 14, 13, 12, 11. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Self-destruct has been aborted. Self-destruct has been aborted.
Oh.
Well, at least I won the bet.
Well, why don't you put your money where your mouth is?
I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to rack them up.
Why don't you just do that?
This is the guy who put green curtains in the rec room.
What do you got? Some brandy. Is that all? You ran out of bourbon. All right. There you go. Thanks. Don't mention it. Great stuff.
Some very strange readings. I think someone has activated the transporter.
That's Osorio beaming the bubonic plague over to Lear's ship.
But, sir, the readings indicate that...
I don't care what the readings indicate. In the future, don't interrupt me when I'm winning at pool.
Another game. Double or nothing.
I'm a double.
Yes.
Win, Potter.
Osorio to captain.
Layton here.
Sir, we've got a slight problem down here on the transporter. I think you better get down here right away.
What happened this time?
I think you better come down and see for yourself.
I'll be right there.
Okay, welders, let's move out. Children, you guard.
Probably drop the bottle of bubonic clay again.
Oh, no.
Gordon! Don Monty! Meet me in the transport room. I'm the double. This is an emergency. Come on, Hans.
He's a real idiot. He keeps doing these
things. What the hell is going on?
There's trouble in the transport room. Come on, quickly.
Explanation for all of this.
Logic. I'm sick to death of logic. That's all Del Monte ever gives me.
Emotional, isn't he?
Yes, quite. He's been this way for some time.
Indeed. Why do you think they saw fit to hire?
And you, Pond, you said the bubonic plague over to where I was. How could you do such a thing?
You deserved it, you glorified ape.
Hey, you can't talk that way about my boss.
Dead, Alex.
Ensign, you've blown it. I tried to be a good welder. I followed all the rules and now it's all destroyed. I tried to be a good welder.
You murderer. You killed him. He was an incompetent communications officer. He was a lousy actor. But he was my friend and that's gotta count for something.
Somebody, don't!
Majority. Hey, that's good stuff. Right in the knee.
Really? I mean, I'm serious. I mean it. I was late on two of my applications. Guidance with the transfer.
Hold him still.
And really, I update school lunch.
Oh my God, Anthony, you've gained weight.
Do something for him. I have more important things to worry about.
Like what?
Like how the hell I'm going to enter this in the log. Captain's log, supplemental. Due to some unexplained difficulty, the infernal welder squad, led by the infamous Anthony Coates, has returned from Leer's ship. In several unrelated incidents, communications officer Dan Gordon was accidentally killed while cleaning his laser on the bridge. I recommend highest commendation for his service to Melville, but not for his acting. I'm also sorry to report that science officer Thomas Dalamonte was electrocuted while in a stupor resultant from a relapse of an undetected mental instability. Ensign David Solo was killed by a falling virus jar, and Lieutenant Anthony Coates, apparently despondent over the deaths of his friends, has suffered a nervous breakdown. I am confident that Dr. Pond will be able to return Lieutenant Coates to some level of competence. perhaps more than he had previous to his collapse. While on special mission to Leer's ship, the lieutenant returned with several artifacts which are considered highly valuable.
Partner, so you got something for an upset stomach?
Try Mountain Dew.
This program would not have been possible with the support of the Antoine Butelli Foundation, Mobil Oil Corporation, and your membership dollars.
You mean we're on? Live?
Due to technical difficulties beyond our control, Paul Barkin has just destroyed the WMHS. Now, Paul, what are you doing here? No! Paul!